Hello everyone, this is Jeff, and I am back with another arcade video, and I am very excited about this one. I've got to tell you, it has nothing to do with what I'm pointing at right now, but I did want to show you, before I introduce what this video is about, how I restructured my arcade. I actually ended up putting my bar top in my workshop here, so you can see my little workshop. It's kind of dark in here at the moment, and a little laundry room, so we can, while we're doing our laundry, we can play a little pinball. I got my cool sign up there that I got off this really nice guy on eBay. Play pinball here because I have got virtual pinball on this machine, and there's a reason that I moved this in here because of my small amount of space that I have. So I'll go ahead and walk out here into my area. Of course, I've got the old centipede there, and I got my cocktail over there. You can see a Galaga in the distance, and what you can see here is the Joust. Dun, 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 dun. I'm going to show you this Joust that I picked up at Coin Op Warehouse, Lloyd, up there in Hagerstown, and I am so excited about this Joust. I'm going to flip over to a video here in just a second. Actually, I'll do it right now. I'll flip over to a video that shows you kind of like when I first got it, and then also when I finally got it here at my house and sat in the shed for a little while because I didn't have any space for it. But I fiddled around with it out there, and I got this non-working, extremely dirty, just covered with dust, and this is the results now. So hold on, I'll be right back, and let me show you how things started with this Joust.
He's got an old wagon. You know, just all kinds of cool stuff here. He's got a Burger King sign, Popeye's sign. This huge Sylvania television, and I did find what I was looking for and something else that I can't pass up. I did find my centipede control panel, which is an old centipede control panel, which will work because it's got the hole in it. They've turned it into some golf thing, but all I needed was the panel. And what thing I couldn't pass up, my highly number one coveted machine, Joust. And I will talk to you more about that Joust later, but this baby's not working, and it's very dirty, but side art is in decent shape, and this side art is a paint, a stencil on the wood, which is really cool. And this is just going to have to go into the work warehouse for a little while, but very, very excited about that. So I will be back later on, but that is the tour of Coin Op Warehouse here in Hagerstown, Maryland. Okay, everyone, here she be, the Joust. I just picked this up at Coin Op Warehouse in Hagerstown, Maryland, and I am extremely happy, very, very excited about picking up a Joust, being able to find one out there. It is non-working, it is extremely dirty, and it will definitely be a project, but I gotta say the side art is in really good shape. It will need some touches up, you know, here and there. The W over here is looking kind of rough, and this side, you know, just needs cleaning. But I mean, look at that. That's nice. That stencil looks nice. The marquee's in good shape. The bezel's in good shape. I'm gonna have to peel that off there from the video game vendor. This control panel, I'll want to turn this into a multi-Williams, but at the moment, the control panel is filthy. Look at this. It's nasty. But it might actually clean up. You just never know. Coin door. Don't know. They got something down there where they pulled the money out. You know, it's complete. It's got the monitor in there. There's the monitor. Not even sure exactly what it is yet. I don't know if you can see that, but it's 19VMCP22. I don't know, I'll figure it out. But there's the board set right there on the door. So I mean, it's a complete Joust. Soundboard, I think, is in there. Power supply, transformer, coin door, everything. And I got this. I think that might be the other part of the door, which covers the monitor up here. I'm not positive, but that closes like that. But really, really excited about this Joust. But just wanted to show you a real quick overview of what I picked up, and work will be done on this much later after the other things that I've got going on. But really, really excited. So talk to you again soon. All right, everybody. I just had to do this. So here is my Joust machine sitting in my shed because I have no room in the house yet. This is something I picked up non-working, and I ended up getting a monitor from someone on the forum there for Facebook. And it was a Williams monitor, and it was working, so I thought I'd blow it out and get all the dust off of it and put it in this thing. And when I first fired it up before, it was just all green on the monitor. And then the only other thing that I obviously noticed, because I don't know a lot about this, was the batteries were, of course, in very nasty shape right there. So I just replaced the batteries. But the inside really looks pretty good. I'm gonna show you this later, but I just had to do a quick video to snap in here and show you that it works. Oh my goodness. Look at this. This thing is working. I can actually work it. The sound is messed up. A couple of the switches don't work. But the two-player one works. It's a little blurry, isn't it? But I just wanted to show you guys that. One of the coin doors is... I mean, there's definitely work. It's very dusty, very dirty. I mean, look at that. It's nasty looking. But Joust is playing, man. The boards are working. I'm just really, really, really excited about that. I was going to put a multi-board in this. J-Rock. I still may do that, but this is making me second guess that. And if this board is working, I might just leave it alone. So we'll see what happens. But I want to show you that. Talk to you later. Bye. Okay, I'm back. And as you can see, it was really, really dirty. When I got it home and I fiddled around with it and just pulled some cables off the boards and put them back on, I was able to get the thing working. I actually got the sound working. I got everything working when I got it in here. And just to try to show you here in the dark, this is what the control panel looks like now. I mean, it was so dirty and dusty, and I just used Simple Green and the Magic Eraser sponge, and it just cleaned up beautifully. I've got some light bulbs coming, because these will actually light up. So I've got the light bulbs that burn out for there, and the light bulbs for the coin door are burnt out, but I'll have that. I got to get that master lock off there. I don't know if you can see that. It's really dark, but the coin box has got this old master lock on there. I have to get some snips to get that off of there. But I mean, the side art on this thing is awesome. I'll just touch it up a little bit with some brown probably. But I mean, it's really, really good shape. I mean, look at this. Let me show you that side. I'll try to do a little bit more video of it when it's a little bit lighter, you know, during the day. I can get some more light in here. But the marquee is in good shape. It's in perfect shape, as a matter of fact. I cleaned this all out, cleaned the bezel. It's got a couple little spots. You can't really see it, so it doesn't make much difference, but there's like a couple little spots where it's peeling on the back, but
not really much at all. Joysticks, buttons are in good shape. But at the moment, for some reason or other, the sound flaked out on me. So there is a short in it somewhere. I don't know where it is. But the cool thing is that I originally got this and I was going to do a multi-Williams setup because I've got a J-Rock board. And if you don't know what a J-Rock board is, I'll go over that here later in the video. Because what I did decide to do, because I was very torn with this, on keeping this original versus turning it into a multi-game. And so what I'm going to do, because of my limited space, and as you can see, you know, that out there is, you know, my wife does her massages when she has clients, and this is our, sort of our, you know, whatever, multi-purpose room. We watch our movies and stuff out here, but that's really all I have is that space right there, because we're in a townhouse. So that's why I have the Centipede with multi-game, Cocktail with multi-game. The Galaga is not, it's a dedicated, and the board's running great on that. But I decided for space issues, I'm going to go ahead and put the multi-game in there, but I'm going to keep all this original. So I've got a new control panel that I'll show you here shortly. I got it from Arcade Shop, and it's a multi-Williams control panel. So I'll pull this control panel off as is and put it to the side. And I'm going to mount the boards, I say boards because I'll surprise you with what I'm going to do. And I'm going to put those and I'm going to mount them in the cabinet, but I'm going to leave all the boards in there. And I've got these wiring harnesses coming from this other website, and I'll tell you about that when they come in. But it allows me to basically use all of the components in here. All the wiring and everything, so I can kind of leave it as is. So I won't keep blabbering about that. So I just wanted to kind of introduce and tell you what I'm going to be doing. But I'm going to be doing a lot of stuff, making this into multi-Williams. But there's the Joust, and I'll be back with the parts here in a few minutes. So I'll talk to you later. Okay, we are unboxing this box here. My son is helping me out.
Yep, I'm unboxing it. I get to unbox something when I first...
I know what's in here.
I don't.
He doesn't.
It is...
And it is...
plastic board.
T-molding!
Oh, that.
And I've got some orange T-molding for the Joust cabinet. And we're going to see what that looks like. I got that idea from TNT Amusements, and I've also got some leather simulated T-molding, and then some black. And then this one that he's already opened before I even got home has joysticks. And I will go over those joysticks here shortly, but these are groovy Game Gear joysticks. Leaf switch joysticks, but new ones. So I'll go over those soon. And then we've got one down here, which is really exciting. Oh, it has to have the peanuts, doesn't it?
And the green ones.
The awesome peanuts. Watch your fingers there, buddy. All right. And this... Here, shoot the video, I'll pull it out. You gonna pull it out?
Just pull it.
Go ahead.
Does my magical penis get out?
Well, but don't rip it out, but, you know, go ahead. We'll clean the mess up. It's exciting. And that is the control panel from Arcade Shop. Very cool. Let's sit down like that. And of course it's got the plastic on there, but this is a multi-Williams control panel. And I will be back to show you that a little bit here in a moment. All right, guys. I've got the control panel from Arcade Shop right here. Okay. So what you can see is, let me bring it over here. All right,
It's got these cool, I don't know what they're called. I'm sure they use a term for it, embedded screws, which is great because you can put your control panel overlay over top of it. So then there's nothing sticking up. And so these sit there just like that. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do yet. I'm trying out joysticks. But to get it to fit that, I would have to use a different joystick than I actually was thinking about. I'm going to do a little review on these later, but and they're all taken apart right now, but these are from Groovy Game Gear or something like that, this website that I found, and these are brand new Leaf Switch joysticks. That's the bottom right there. And they really work quite nicely. There's not a lot of tension on them like these other old style joysticks, in the sense of when you move it around, it's a little, you know, a little bit looser. But I had these hooked up in my to test the thing right here, right? So you guys have seen that on my, but I have, this is my test thing. And I had it hooked up and played a game of Robotron, and it was really quite good. But these are smaller in size with the holes, unfortunately. I don't know why they would do that. So they won't fit. I'd have to drill holes in that thing. So, but I also have, from the old Devastators cabinet that's now a Centipede cabinet, I have these official original Wico, is that what they, WICO, Wico joysticks, Wico, whatever. Can't see it in there, but it's got the there it is, if you can see it, WICO Corporation. Anyway, and so I've taken these apart and kind of cleaning them out. So I have one extra. I had one in the Centipede, but I just pulled it out right now to try this out, because really these are what was in the original Robotrons. And for multi-Williams, Joust is fine. Defending, you know, I mean, I think for Robotron, these would really be nice joysticks. And I had to change this one here. I had to add a Leaf. I only had fiber, but I think this is going to work just fine. I got those from Bob Roberts, these fiber button switches, gold flashed contacts, and I think it's going to fit in there just fine. You can see that or not. So I got one of them in here now. Now granted, it's got a blue ball on it, and then the other one is a red ball, but I thought I'd just show you how these things come apart. This in here is what makes it kind of special. Right, so, but this one you can see, if I can push on this and not hard enough, I push on that, see, it's all cracked. I'm sure I can eventually find some replacements for that, but then again, I don't know, because these are kind of hard to come by. But I think it's fine, there's nothing wrong with it. I just got all the dust out of there, and so then this is kind of how it goes together. Right, so you put that part in there first, and then you put this in. It slides down in there. And then this piece is like a little washer that goes over top. And then this would go over the top here. And then these screws will go down in there. And then when you put your joystick up in there like that, then you would put this over top, and then this plastic piece over top like that. There's a little groove there. That part goes down, and then you put your little clip on it. And then apparently, you know, these dust protectors are supposed to go underneath, which I didn't do for testing, but they would go underneath, not actually on top of the control panel. Which, the way these are designed, these would just go over top. So, I don't know. We'll see what I do with that. Anyway, I just wanted to show you this and kind of show you how that goes back together. But I think that I'm going to end up playing with these. Robotron had 4-inch joysticks, apparently. These are not 4-inch. I don't even know if these are 3.5-inch. I think they are, but I don't know where they measure from. You know? Like, this is not 3.5 inches to that spot, but we'll see. Anyway, they're definitely longer than these. You can see that this is a bit shorter, but I was okay with it. But we'll see what happens. Just want to show you that. I'll be back.
All right, here's some of the first testing of the Multi-Williams in the Joust machine. There's the menu. This is for now one, yeah. Now that takes you into it, and then press it. That guy moves you. This one shoots, remember? Remember hot plate now?
Yeah. Sorry. Those people, are those people?
Yeah, you want to pick them up.
No!
You gotta shoot to the right. There you go.
Person!
Those big guys you can't shoot. Kill that circle.
Jordan! No!
Get those guys.
I hate this game.
You're good at it, Wes.
Yum, 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 yum! Mushroom people.
He shot you.
Well, this game is hard.
All right, guys. Here we go. The moment of truth. This is my Multi-Williams control panel overlay. Got this from arcadeoverlays.com, and I worked pretty hard back and forth emailing with the guy there, Todd, who is a really good guy. And this is one of the two control panel overlays for Multi-Williams that I know of. I know you can get the other one from Arcade Shop. You might be able to get it from some other places. But I really wanted this particular one. I like the colors in it. I like everything about it. But I got the control panel from Arcade Shop. And this doesn't, the holes don't line up correctly. I tried to make a scan of this. I've had, this is one of the reasons that I couldn't end up getting you a video sooner. Is I've just had some trouble with this control panel matching up with the control panel overlay. I tried to get a scan of this. It just wasn't going to work out where he could redo the holes. So I'm going to take a shot and just see if I can get them to line up correctly in some fashion. So I'm going to go ahead and open this up. I can't do it one-handed, but I just wanted to show you the box and let you know what's going to be in it. I'm going to go and see if these holes line up, and then I'll show you show it to you when it's folded out, and I'll let you know how the holes line up. So here we go, and let's see what happens. All right, folks. I debated on whether to film this because it was a very frustrating experience, but I thought I would share it with you so that
if anybody actually watches this and is going to do a Multi-Williams, you will know not to do what I did. So if you are going a Joust, and I think actually Defender probably, but I know that the Joust, this particular graphic, I really like this graphic. Other than the other one that's out there floating around, it really works well with the Joust. So what I did was I got this panel right there, as you can see, a really nice Multi-Williams panel from Arcade Shop with the holes already drilled in it. Awesome panel, but this graphic does not match this one. I know two people that sell this graphic, and neither one of them could end up moving the stuff around here, these holes around. I'm going to show you real quick. This is player 2, and this is the hyperspace.
The distance between here and here is about 3+ inches. The distance on the graphic, as you can see, is less than 2 inches. You can tell right there that it's definitely a lot shorter. So a lot of the buttons are off. These are definitely off. This one's off. These two are off. I think that one's even off a little bit. So I just can't make it work. So I had to bite the bullet because I had already drilled holes in this. I couldn't return it. But it's still quite salvageable. I just can't return it. There's nothing wrong with it. So what I ended up doing was I got a blank Multi-Williams. So this is the blank one that Arcade Shop sells. So I can do my own holes. I needed to drill another hole anyway for a button that I'm going to show you. I don't know if, what part of the video you're watching at the moment, but you may or may not know what I'm doing. But I need an extra button for that. And so this is going to work great with that graphic. So what I actually did was when I ordered this, I went ahead and ordered the other Arcade Shop graphic that goes on that panel right there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put the graphic on, and I'm going to sell the graphic and the panel as a kit to anyone that needs a Multi-Williams. I'm going to ask the guys out on my Facebook forums and stuff, and if I need to, just maybe on eBay or whatever. But this way, you know, the graphic's already there. I think that it'll be more appealing for people to buy it. So again, bite the bullet. Spent more money than I wanted to. I'm going to lose a little money on the sale there because it's not used, but it's, you know, sort of used. Anyway, I wanted to show you that, but I'm really excited about this now. I'm going to go ahead and put that on here. I'm going to lay it over there, mark my holes, drill my holes, get everything ready, and put that on there. So I will talk to you later after I get that done. Alright guys, I have talked about this board right here, and I wanted to show you what I'm really going to end up doing here, maybe showing you this after the fact, so that you can understand exactly how I got this to work the way I did. This is the J-Rock board right here, okay? This is the Multi-Williams J-Rock board that runs Defender, Robotron, Joust, and five others. All right, Defender, I think I said Defender. Got a lot of great, awesome games. I believe this is the CPU area right here. Which one is it? Is it that one or that one? I don't know. I know that it's an awesome board, and it works great. And that's what I had planned for my Multi-Williams and my Joust. But what I was wanting was what is also on this board, which is this is an old Arcade Shop board, which is the predecessor to the Arcade SD, right? So this is an old Arcade Shop board, and it will run about 20 horizontal games, and it's got games like Mario Brothers, Moon Patrol, Berserk, Frenzy, Wizard of War, a lot of great games that I want to play horizontally that this one doesn't have. And I could run Defender and Joust and all those games off of this board as well, but I really want the authentic feel of Robotron and Defender and things like that from the J-Rock board. Now, I have both of these boards sitting here, and you can see they're kind of hooked up, but the trick was a JAMA switcher, right? And this is not just any old JAMA switcher. I actually tried it with my original JAMA switcher that I had, which I think I can pull out real quick and show you. All right, I'll just show you what I had. Should have had that out too to show you. All right, so this was the original JAMA switcher that actually works, but it doesn't have all the functionality that I need for these multi-games. Right, this is a nice JAMA switcher. It actually comes with, I'm pulling it out now here, hold on a second. This little switch, gotta flip that down, right? And that switches it over I'm not crazy about the remote idea, but that's what it does. There's a thing that transceiver, transmitter, whatever, that hooks up to this. And this is, you know, this is, how much did I pay for this? $35, $40, $50, something like that. A long time ago, never ended up using it. Tried to use it, but for these boards, to get in and out of games, you have to hit player one and player two. Well, that JAMA switcher right there doesn't like it. So I researched and I found Mike's Arcade JAMA switch. And they call it the double JAMA, right? They even got it marked, double JAMA. And this board is a lot more expensive. It's over $100, but it is well worth it for what I want. It has a lot of, it has the functionality that I need. But for these particular games, I didn't think it was going to work because it wasn't. So let me put this back here real quick. And it wasn't working. So I was emailing back and forth with Mike, Mike's Arcade. And he said, well, the Arcade Shop board and the Arcade SD, I couldn't get that to work on here. So he said that they have to, for the one and two player to work, I learned this whole electrical thing that I didn't know before, which is that there needs to be a constant low current coming to the board at all times for it to recognize it and for it to be able to switch back and forth. So it's like a low voltage thing. So what I had to do is, well, let me tell you. All right, this is the main JAMA harness that comes in, right? So you would normally hook up any board to this one. So you hook the JAMA switcher up to this board. And then off of here, I've got, you can hook up a board here, but because I didn't want to hack up this JAMA harness and the other harness that I actually will show you later, I didn't want to hack that up, so I used this extender JAMA harness for now. And this is the way I have it hooked up. And then this harness goes over to the Arcade Shop board. And then on this side, this is the homemade harness. This is a harness that comes with the switcher. And then that goes over to the J-Rock. Now it's going to boot up to this one first, but that's just the way I wanted it to boot to this one first, but it's going to boot to this one first because I'm using it this way. Because what you have to do is this is the brown wire, and this is the other brown wire, and these happen to be player one and player two, or player one and player two, I'm not sure. And I just used some thicker wire that I had loose, and what you do is you cut that wire, you splice another wire into it, and then you run these two wires right over here, and zoom in on that, to the 5 volts. Right, plus 5 volts, right? It's the same plus 5 volts that you hook up this board to, right? So you plug it into that, but you don't want plus 5 volts running to this all the time. So the thing I had to find out about is I had to have a resistor in there. So this is very makeshift right now, and it's in a non-soldering way, so don't make fun of me. These little things right here, hopefully you can see that. That is a tiny resistor. Drawing a blank on what size it is. Maybe I have the bag floating around here somewhere because I'm doing these videos at different times. Here we go. Radio Shack, right? I think I ripped it off the top. Shoot, I'd have to look it back up. Right. Carbon film resistors. It had to be a certain ohm. I think it was 10K, right? It was a 10K resistor, right? So that's what I was suggesting. Now, obviously, these are for soldering. You can see on this board right here, there's already a resistor soldered onto this board for another reason. Now, I could take these resistors and I could solder them onto this board in the right spots, but I am not about to do that and ruin my board. Right, so, and I actually bought these other ones, these other 10K resistors. Sorry if I'm digging through here to find stuff
and you're not seeing anything but blank nothingness.
Can't find them right off the bat. Here they are. I bought these resistors. They're way over spec, but you can actually not have to solder, and you can put a little, if you can see that or not, because it's shiny. You can actually just put a little clip on it. So I can use these, and then just use the little clips, like for all the gym harness, these'll fit on there, those clips. But I think I might just leave these on here, tie it up, and I might just do some electrical tape and be done with it for now. Because it works. It works fine. I've spliced together stuff my whole life without soldering. I know I'm going to have to dive into soldering more than I have recently. But for now, I just wanted to show you this is how it works. You can hack the board, or you can just hack into the wires. Right, so what that does is this gives you a very low current, right? So you don't get the whole plus 5 volts. You just get whatever you get, right? 10K. And then that gives it a very low current to player 1 and player 2, and it keeps it closed all the time. So then the board here will recognize it. Hopefully that makes sense. If it doesn't make sense, let me know. I got diagrams that I figured out, because I just figured this out myself, but I got it working. Now the cool thing about this switcher is it doesn't use one of those little remote controls. You can actually use one player, two player to switch between boards, but I don't want to do that because I use that to get out of the game menu. So he added a jumper. I take this jumper off right here, and I can use button 26 or 24 or something like that. And if I use that button, well then I can switch between games like that. So let me just show you how it works here. Like I said, I might have already showed you. I don't know when I'm putting this video in there. But as soon as I plug this in, I'll tell you exactly when I plug it in. I'm plugging it in now. That's how quick the Arcade Shop board comes up. And I really could hook an Arcade SD up to this, but I had this Arcade Shop board and had it for a long time, and I really like that background. But you can see these are all the games. I'll go ahead and let them just run through. Rally X and New Rally X. Some of these I may not play. It was just the horizontals that were on there. Pinball. We'll see how that works. Soccer. And then, of course, Wizard of War. And it goes back to Berserk. Okay? And now, if I just press this button right here, I'll go ahead and just, you can maybe hear it click. It clicks right over to the J-Rock board. And now there's the J-Rock board, right? Defender White ROM, which I don't know the difference, Stargate, Robotron, Joust, Bubbles, Splat, Blaster, Sinistar, and Sinistar OMOA, which I don't know what that means either, and then my setup. And then if I want to go back to Berserk or whatever, to the other board, and it leaves it in the state that it was in, right? So if I'm in Robotron, and I start that up, well then now it's in Robotron. Right? If I click back over, well it just goes back to wherever this board was. And it's just scrolling through its sort of there. And then every once in a while it stops at certain ones and it goes back. Now if I click back, then it's back on Robotron. So both these boards are powered on at the same time, which is really cool. So I'll end up putting another button somewhere to be able to do that. And then when I'm also in the Arcade Shop, well then you've got the menu system, right? So then I've got my little test button here. So if I click this test button, well that takes me into the Arcade Shop menu button, which is very similar to the Arcade SD. Not quite as extensive, but you can get to all different kinds of stuff in here for each game setup and whatnot. And then I just switch back. So now I can have all these great games in one big fashion. Like I said, I could get, I think, almost every game off the J-Rock board on this one too. But I really wanted to do it this way because I want the J-Rock authenticity. That's what the purists go for, and I really like it. I just love playing Robotron on that. So I know this is a very long section of the video, but I wanted to just show you how this is all hooked up. I'll show you again once I have it in the cabinet, which I still got to figure out how I'm going to do that. But that is that, and then just let me know if you have any questions on that section, if I made sense or not.
Hey guys, I just wanted to finish up here with the last bit of information. Hopefully that's part one. I've had a lot of trouble with this so far. I've learned a lot. I'm already further than what you're seeing here in this video, but I wanted to get something posted. I had planned to do it all in one shot, but I've had to do so many different things, and even went back to when I first got the Joust machine. That there's plenty in for one video here. It's kind of all over the place, but hopefully you get some things out of it, and you're kind of seeing how I'm doing. I've got a lot of other things to do here. Obviously got some holes to drill in the control panel, and that's one of my big sections. I've had some other hurdles that I'll tell you about later, but that is part one, and I will be back for part two. And until then, game on.